Good evening, everyone. Trust your day is good. We are live on Amiable Women of Honor Facebook live stream of our Bible study. And I pray that as we share the word of God together this evening, as we read together, I pray our life will not remain the same. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you, Lord, we bless your holy name. We give you praise, honor, and adoration in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the gift of life that you have given unto us, even to see the month of grace. We also thank you, Almighty Father, King of Glory, for another time to share your word in your presence. Father, I pray. May your name be glorified in our lives in Jesus' name. The Bible says, the entrance of your word giveth light and it giveth understanding unto the simple. As we share your word today, because your word has solution to every problem that a believer may be facing. I pray your word will bring forth fruit in our life. In our situation, in Jesus' name. And all glory and all honor will be yours in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Just as I've said, my sisters, my auntie, my mother watching me all over the world, I pray that this evening, as we share the word of God together, our life will not remain the same in Jesus' name. We'll be sharing from the summary of our Bible study on the topic that says bearing one another through godly partnership. I repeat, bearing one another through godly partnership. And our text is taken from the book, the last two chapters in the book of Romans, chapters 15 and chapter 16. Chapter 15 and chapter 16. That is where we'll be drawing our message from this evening. Praise the Lord. From the topic of today, from the topic we'll be sharing today, bearing one another through godly partnership. There are two significant words that we have to bear in mind as we, progress in this Bible study. One is bearing, and another one is partnership. Bearing, and another one is partnership. What does it mean to bear? To bear means to be responsible for something. To bear means to support. To bear means to also share. The second word from our topic is partnership. What is partnership? Partnership is a relationship between two people, nation, group, that work together regularly. That work together regularly. That is what partnership is. I pray as we progress, may the Lord minister to us in Jesus' name. Yes, Romans chapters 15 and verse 16. That is where we'll be taking our Bible passage from. And I'll be reading from chapters 15, verse 1 to 7. Let us quickly read that so we'll be able to deduce something from there. We then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak and not to please ourselves. Let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification. For even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of them that reproached thee fell on me. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scripture might have hope. Verse 5. Now the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded, one towards another, according to Christ Jesus, that ye may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 7. Wherefore, receive ye one another, as Christ also received us to the glory of God. Don't forget, the topic says, bearing one another through godly partnership. Point 1 from what was deduced says, Apostle Paul admonished that the strong believers should help the weak believers to understand and to outgrow their spiritual weaknesses. In other words, all believers are also expected to seek to live in such a way that all may grow in faith. Christ demonstrated this in his lifetime by pleasing God and himself. We are instructed to put up with the weakness of others. As we grow out of our spiritual weaknesses, doctrinal misunderstanding, etc. What is this place talking about? It's talking to us. It's talking to older Christians. It's talking to us as believers that we should be able to bear one another. We should be able to support one another. Take for instance, yesterday at the Redeemer, the Holy Ghost service. In fact, my mother in the Lord and my father in the Lord, Pastor Adeboye, in fact, they trigger my faith yesterday. They boost my faith. They make me have the strength to forge ahead in this Christian's race, coming from the background I came from. That's a very good example of older believers, of older Christians, who should, uplift the weaker ones when situation or circumstances that we did not plan for, that we did not pray to happen to us as believers. Praise the Lord. Older believers should be able to, bear, support the younger believers. That is what Apostle Paul is encouraging us in the first 9 verses of this chapter, especially the verse 7. Wherefore, receive ye one another, as Christ also received us to the glory of God. Praise the Lord. He asks that God will give us Christ's kind of thinking towards one another, so that we may glorify God. We must always pray the same prayer, that his work might prosper in our hands. And I pray, just as Apostle Paul said, the work of God will prosper in our hands in Jesus' name. The second point says, against what most people say and believe, Paul actually loved and valued women, and they were not only his followers, but partners in ministry. Little wonder. That is why women are the more in the church today. Praise the Lord. Women are the most in every church, because they are in the forefront of the ministry. Any church that there is no woman, any fellowship that there is no woman, they should check it out. Because women have the drive, they have the spirit, they have the courage to bring out anything or good thing from any project. And I pray we'll be co-partners with Jesus in our different ministries, in our different calling, in Jesus' name. Amen. Paul was talking about partnership. He traveled and ministered with men and women alike, and he called them co-workers in our different parishes, in our different churches that we belong to, as usher, as choir, as counselors, as prayer warrior. We are co-workers working with the pastor to achieve a goal. And what is the goal? To bring lost souls into the kingdom of God. To bring lost souls into the kingdom of God. So we are co-laborers. So let's not forget, this is a woman forum. And Romans chapter 16 catalog 28 people who were ministry partners with Paul, and 10 of them were women. They were young, old, rich, prisoners, and all. So in whichever category you find yourself as a woman, whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are of the average, whether you are knowledgeable, whether you are educated or not, you can work for God. You can be co-laborers, you can be co-workers with Him, depending on the department you want to function. Praise the Lord. In that Romans chapter 16, Apostle Paul mentioned some women, of which is listed here. Phoebe, servant and helper of many matron and sponsor. She's an example. Another one is Prisca or Priscilla, married and a missionary with her husband. When some women will be saying, it is my husband that God called. God did not call me. I cannot become Yayad. No. I don't want to do that. This is the example of somebody, Priscilla. The Bible said she's married and missionary in the work of God with her husband. Mary is another person. Tryphena is another person. Tryphosa is another person. Persis, they were referred as co-laborers with Paul. Another person is Junia, who was in prison with her husband for the gospel with Paul. They even went to the prison. When little or some situation will happen to us, even as worker in our various parishes, even as worker in whichever department we find ourselves, we start complaining. Junia went to prison because of the gospel of Christ. Another person is Rufus' mother, probably a grandmother, Celsa, a partner too in ministry. Nesros was also mentioned here. Julia, a member in ministry. Despite the patriarchal system and practices that existed in Paul's time, these women stood out in their ministry and partnership. What are they saying? During the time of Paul, it is the man that is in charge. It is the man's voice that ought to be heard, not women. And yet, these women, they did a lot for the gospel. They did a lot for the king's business.
They did a lot with their pastor, who is Apostle Paul, in this place. And maybe Women of Honor Ministry is another partnership we can employ to fulfill our great commission. You can join the Amiable Women of Women platform to showcase your talent. Two, is it in prayers, in supporting the ministry with prayer, in finance, in counseling, in teaching? You are welcome as women so that we can rub each other's back, so that we can teach each other, so that we can encourage each other. Don't forget, the title of our topic is Bearing One Another Through Godly Partnership. True godly partnership. The third point here is taken from Romans chapters 15, from verse 10 to 23. Summarized. Christ was a servant to both the Jews to confirm the promises of God to their fathers, and the Gentiles to glorify God for his mercy. And Apostle Paul wants Jews and Gentiles to accept each other and serve each other as Christ did. He prays that both Jews and Gentiles believers will have joy, peace, and hope by the power of the Holy Ghost. Apostle Paul is confident about the Romans' relationship with each other. And even though he admonishes them, he commends them for their desire and ability to serve. As a priest of the gospel, he was after the service being acceptable by the Holy Spirit. He was not only interested in what Christ has done through him. Praise the Lord. What are they saying here? We must realize we are just vessels in the hand of God. Hence, our priority should be in our service is acceptable to him and not to please ourselves. Just as we used to encourage ourselves in the partnership for a platform, that we are working for God. We are working for God. And it is he that will reward our labor of love. Apostle Paul was not after his own self. He was not after his own gain. But he was after the praise of God. He was after the welfare of his brethren. Praise the Lord. Romans chapter 15 from verse 24 to 29. It was deduced there that he wanted to visit them on his way to Spain. Who are we talking about? Apostle Paul. But first, he must go to Jerusalem to deliver the money that the churches of Macedonia and Asia have collected. What is that saying? That his financial integrity is at stake here. That is financial integrity. Most of us, we cannot joke with our money. Money cannot be entrusted in our hands. I have heard stories, I've heard testimony of people working in the ushering department, even families as usher that were stealing from God. Church money, the people's money, they were stealing it. That did not happen in the case of Apostle Paul. He said he had to return the money he collected. Praise the Lord. As ambassador of Christ, as women, as unable women of honor, as a woman of virtue, as a virtuous woman, our integrity should be all-encompassing If we cannot be trusted with finance, then our gospel will be made mockery of. Our gospel will be making mockery of. Some people, when they borrow, they will not pay back. They will not even mention it. That shouldn't be our case. When we borrow from our fellow woman, we should endeavor to pay back. If she now says, okay, go with it, fine. But still mention it. If you don't have it, ah, my sister, I don't have it now, but I will pay later. I will pay you. It shows that you have the person in mind to pay back. Praise the Lord. The second point, the fifth point says, it was taken from Romans chapters 5, from 30 to 33. Apostle Paul requested that the Roman believers should pray for him in his ministry for protection, that his service will be acceptable to the believers, and afterwards he will have joy and rest when it comes to Rome. What is he saying? We shouldn't be self-sufficient in ourselves to think we don't need the prayers of others in this journey of faith. Hence, we must not forsake the assembly of one another. Just as our Father in the Lord, I'll keep making reference to him, Pastor Adeboye, at the level at which they are operating, still request we as members, we as workers, to pray for him, to pray for his family. Our pastor in our various parishes, in our various churches, needs our prayer. One way or the other, as the Holy Spirit is helping us. Praise the Lord. The sixth point says, is taken from Romans 16, from verse 1 to 16. Apostle Paul recommends Phoebe to the Roman believers. Can you be recommended? Can you be recommended? Can your pastor recommend you in your church? Can your pastor recommend you? Can your pastor recommend you? Can other believers recommend you? What is your character? Phoebe was recommended by Paul to the Roman believers. As Christians, we are to help one another in their affairs, especially strangers, but of the same faith in Christ. I am a redeemer. I have CCG. I don't have business with the person going to government. I don't have business with the person going to Lord Chosen. I don't have business with the person going to Mountain of Fire. No, it shouldn't be. He's talking about Christian believers. Since we are of the same faith, since it is Christ that binds all of us together, we shouldn't discriminate. Praise the Lord. We may not know what help we may need ourselves for in the future. Apostle Paul asked for help for Phoebe, who had been helpful to many. He said, whatever you sow, you will reap. As amiable women of honor, as women, it is recorded that Phoebe, don't forget, in his recommendation in that Romans chapter 16, that he was of help to many matron and sponsor. She has been of help to many people. Whatever you sow, you will reap. That was why Apostle Paul could recommend her. And when it was time, when she was also in need, people rose up. People came to her aid to do what? To help her. He that watereth shall be watered also himself. He that watered shall also be watered. And if you have not been watering, If you have not been showing, if you have not been showing care and concern to other women in your environment, in your area, in your church, in your place of work, just because you don't want to show concern, just because you are comfortable, just because you feel you are rich or you are knowledgeable, my sister, my auntie that is watching me all over the world, please repent. Please repent. Please change. We are women and we are for each other. Praise the Lord. Though the care of all the churches came upon Apostle Paul daily, yet he could remember many persons and send salutation to each with particular characters of them, lest any should feel hurt. As if Paul had forgotten them, he sent his remembrance to the rest as brethren and saints. Though not named, he will always add in the close of his letters to the brethren a general salutation to them all as a body of the Church of Christ. It is a great attribute we must emulate as ambassador of Christ, most especially as leaders. If you go through that Romans chapter 16, when you read through, you will see what Apostle Paul did. He asked after everybody. He was concerned about everybody. A pastor that does not show concern, a pastor's wife that does not show concern to the members of his church, will not get members. Our convener in Amebu Women of Honor platform, in person of Mrs. Wafunke, she does that. She does check on me every day. She sends posts to me, words of encouragement to me every day, asking if everything is good, everything is okay with me. That is how it should be. I was even telling one of our member, one of the partners recently, that at the conference, she was taking care of everybody. She took care of us to ask after our well-being. Are we okay? Have we eaten? Have we done that? After the conference, she didn't ask after me. So I had to tell her. And she said she was sorry. It's because of work here and there. It's understandable. We should, as women, look for each other, lift each other up, be concerned for each other, help each other. I don't have to be saying this, but I have to. Recently, even while I was going through some, you know, financial issues, they came to my aid. That is what we should be doing to ourselves as women. That is what we should be doing to ourselves as sisters. Praise God. The seventh point says, I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause division and offense contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. Avoid them. Only because if you want to see, they are everywhere. They are in our place of work. They are in our churches. They are in our environment. They are in our family. That will just purposely want to just, you know, hurt you, or just to start pulling your leg unnecessarily. Even among believers. I, coming from the background I'm coming from, when my family sees, they want to just ask some questions that will just make you to just, you know, want to be angry. But I thank the Holy Spirit, who has always been there for me to give me a ready-made answer for them that will not cause misunderstanding between us. What is the Bible telling us here? He said we should, you know, avoid them. Anything that does not go with the word of God. Anything that is not in line with the word of God. My father in the Lord, Pastor here at Deboye, said anything that is not written in this Bible, he will not preach it. Anything that is not in line with the word of God, he will not preach it, he will not say it. So if he's telling us anything, if he's encouraging us on anything, if he's preaching on anything, he refers to the Bible. Praise the Lord. This is talking about the vessel unto dishonor. We must identify such people prayerfully and watch them so they won't pollute others and even ourselves. Heavenly race is a personal assignment that is linked to others. That is why he who thinks is standing to take heed lest we fall. It is my sincere prayer that we will not fall in Jesus' name. This race that is set before us, by the grace, by the power of God, we won't make it in Jesus' name. Amen. The fall might not even come from within or without. From partners in the race, we must always ask for his grace to overcome. And it is my prayer that we overcome in Jesus' name. Amen. The eighth point here is deduced from Romans 16, from verse 17 to 20. Whatever differs from the sound doctrine of the scripture opens a door to division and offenses. Whatever, anything that does not, that is not based on the scripture, that is against the sound doctrine of the scripture, opens doors for division and offenses. If truth being forsaken, unity and peace will not last long. Unity and love will not last long in such place. Many call Christ Master and Lord, but are far from serving him. Are you part of those that have been warming the bench in the last 10 years in your church, in your parish, doing nothing in the household of God? Not even in the sanitation department to come to clean the church. You are just there, awalawambe, doing nothing. Christ have died for you to serve you. What are you doing in return as a woman? Rather, they serve their carnal, sensual, and worldly interests. They come to show off in the church. They come to cause division in the church. I pray that every woman listening to me all over the world, you will not be part of those in Jesus' name. Amen. We are expected to keep our heart with all diligence, because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. We need to be wise as not to be deceived. Yes, so simple as not to be deceived. Yes, so simple as not to be deceivers. The blessing the Apostle Paul expects from God is victory over Satan, and we will be victorious over him in Jesus' name. Amen. This includes all design and devices of Satan against souls to defy, to disturb, and to destroy them. All his attempts to keep us from the peace of heaven here and the possession of heaven. The wiles of the devil in these last days. We have to be watchful. We have to be careful. Praise the Lord. If the grace of Christ be with us, who can prevail against us? We must be confident in the fact that He is with us always, and the devil cannot overcome us in Jesus' name. Matthew 28, verse 20. It says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the very end of the world. Amen. That's a promise from our Lord Jesus Christ. He's going to be with us always, no matter what the situation of the world is talking about, no matter the terrorism, the banditry, the economic situation all over the world. He's saying here, He will be with us always, even to the end of the world. Amen. The ninth point that was deduced from Romans chapter 15 and verse 16 is taken from that Romans 16 from verse 21 to 24. Apostle Paul always had affectionate remembrance from person with him. Known to the Roman Christian, it is a great comfort to see the holiness and usefulness of our kindred. Not many mighty, nor many noble are called, but some which were able, were also privileged to be among. It is lawful for believers to bear civil offices, and also office in Christian bodies should be bestowed upon prudent and steady Christians. What are they saying here? That many mighty, many noble people are not even called, are not even saved. It is the grace of God that has brought you and I to this fold, to His kingdom. That is why He said that in the Bible that none of us should rejoice, none of us should boast, that it is not by works, but by His grace. There are some people who will not have the opportunity to be saved in their lifetime. But that is not the case of you and I. We were opportuned. And I pray that God, who has brought us into His fold, will keep us, will preserve us to the very end in Jesus' name. As you have been privileged to hold offices and assignment in God's businesses, we must be up and doing, as our services is not unto man but unto God, and He rewards faithful laborers in His vineyard. Somebody once said, I live an accountable life. I will give account of my life to somebody, to the Almighty God, someday, sometime. Whatever it is that we are doing in the vineyard of God, unknowingly or unknowingly, the one that is conspicuous or not, we have a reward for it. God will reward us. That is why the convener of the Amiable Women of Honor Ministry always pray for us as partners and members, that God will reward our sacrifices and our labor of love to the ministry in Jesus' name. We are co-laborers, and there's a reward for everything. I pray the fire will not burn our service, will not burn our work in Jesus' name. Amen. The last point that was deduced from that Romans 15 and verse 16 says, it's taken from Romans 16, 25 to 27. That which establishes souls is the plain preaching of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. That which establishes soul is the plain preaching of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Any program, any church that is not after the soul of men, that is not after the saving of the soul of men, is out of it. In Amiable Women of Honor Ministry, one of our mission is to save homes. Some of our mission is to save women. That we shouldn't die in silence. We should speak up. We should be able to scratch each other's back. We should be able to encourage each other. We should speak up. Praise the Lord. Our redemption and salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ are without controversy. A great mystery of godliness. Much of his mystery will be made plain to us as we draw close to him and bring heaven to our hearts. As we set our affection on things above and we do not willfully neglect so great our salvation. Life and immortality are brought to light by the gospel and the Son of Righteousness is risen on the world. The obedience of faith is that obedience which is paid to the word of faith. What is that saying? We must remember that we are called to the obedience of faith, and that every degree of wisdom is from the only wise God. We should by word and deed render glory to him through our Lord Jesus Christ. So the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with us forever. We cannot do anything of our own. When we depend on our Maker, when we trust in our Redeemer, when we rely solely on the Holy Spirit, in this race, he will help us. He will be with us. Don't let us forget that there are commandments, there are rules, there are instructions that we have to follow as Christians. And I pray that the Almighty God, who has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light, will help and see us through in Jesus' name. Amen. In popular words, they say, bearing one another through godly partnership. Not worldly partnership, not occultic partnership, godly partnership. Who are you partnering with, if I may ask, as a woman? Who are you partnering with? Who are your friends? You should partner with the same people you are of the same faith with. You should help them. You should support them. You should be responsible to them. You should be responsible to each other and help each other. And I pray, just as we have shared today's Bible study together, I pray the grace, the power, just as my father in the Lord, Pastor Ye Adeboye, and Mommy Gio, as exhibited yesterday, as matured Christians, we will also, irrespective of the situation or circumstances that come our way, we'll be able to bear, we'll be able to support ourselves in prayer, in substance, in resources that the Almighty God has given to us in Jesus' name. From this Bible study of today, I know we have learned one thing or the other. The grace, the power to do his will at all times, to do his word at all times, as women of honor, God will give unto us in Jesus' name. Don't let us forget, tomorrow is another time, 9 p.m. that we'll be talking about our well-being, and a guest will be ministering to us along with our convener tomorrow by 9 p.m. You just switch on, and I know you will be blessed in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you, we bless your name. The one whose word is sure, the one whose word is truth, the one whose word is life, we have shared your word today, bearing one another in godly partnership. As women, as mothers, as sisters, the grace to bear one another in their weaknesses, in their shortcomings, in their situation and circumstances. Father, please grant unto us in Jesus' name. That as we climb up the ladder, as we desire to do your will, as we desire to do your work, God Almighty, King of Glory, that our spiritual weaknesses will become strength, that those that are behind us will be able to help them in Jesus' name. Father, we cannot do anything of our own. Father, please help us. The Bible says, we are sealed in the Holy Spirit in this dispensation. Holy Spirit, we can do nothing without you. Please come and help us. Help us as mothers. Help us as women. Help us as sisters in your business. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Amen and amen. Thank you for listening, and I pray our life will not remain the same in Jesus' name. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.